Yo, what's good, YouTube? This is Jake from TNJ, and welcome back to the Lions franchise as we are 8-3 here in Season 7, and we are coming off of a loss versus the Chicago Bears, but we have 5 games left in the season, so in this episode, we will round out this season and head towards the playoffs because we are on track to make it here in Season 7 for, I believe, the 5th straight season. We are now making the playoffs. I believe we missed it in the first two, and now here we are once again. Now, we do have some player upgrades, and I gotta admit, our drafting has been so good, and maybe last year was a down year as far as drafting because we've drafted guys like James Anderson, and James Anderson is literally a top 10 outside linebacker, but he's backing up Rich Patton. So we literally have two of the top 10 right outside linebackers, and that's not even mentioning the left. I mean, this guy is amazing. We've drafted guys like Rich Patton on defense, like Jack Spell on offense, who's progressed from a 70 to a 77, Brian Ryan on defense, a defensive end. I mean, the list goes on. I mean, we have drafted really, really well. I think the one position we haven't drafted, you know, amazing at is corner, but we do have Vincent McLeod, so he is yet to be seen. So here is our first matchup. We're going up against a team that we're really, really familiar with in the Redskins, and here they are early on going for a fake field goal, and look at this. The Redskins have to pull a rabbit out of the hat because they cannot beat us the normal way. And Tim Jackson, the undrafted free agent in Season 1, gets the sack on that one. So here we are back on our offense for our first possession of this episode. And here's the throw out to left side, and we are inside of 2 minutes. And here's Justin Fields trying to hurry it up to the line, finding Keon Knight on that pass. Another pass to the left side. It's going to be Knight again. He's got it in traffic. He just gets better and better as the season goes on. I think Madden actually made a patch to fix catching traffic, and I'm really glad because there were times when, like, I would go against the CPU, and our guys would just straight up not catch anything in traffic, so I'm glad they now catch those contested catches. So here's a throw to the end zone on a first and goal, and that's caught by Hockenson, a touchdown. He is the number 2 rated tight end in the league at this point, and he does make it 7-0. As here we go into the second half now. Here's a handoff this time. Kennedy Brooks on 3rd and inches, and he has not been hitting the ground running this season. You know, he has had a couple of games where he's kind of flashed, but I've not seen it consistently from Kennedy Brooks. Here's a throw out to the left side. This time it's going to be Keon Knight again. He's getting inside the 5-yard line on that catch, and it's a first down as now we're set up at about the 4-yard line from a shotgun throw. Wide open. It is Marlon Yarbrough for the touchdown. And here we go. 14-0 here versus the Redskins, a team that we are just so familiar with. And now we move on to the fourth quarter here with the 13-3 lead. Here is Fields. Another throw across the middle to Galladay. It's going to be knocked away. And that prevents the touchdown. He could have had a hat trick on that one. And that brings it to a 3rd and goal from the 10. There's a flag on the play, but Fields takes it himself. And he does fight forward to the goal line for the touchdown. But this one is coming back. Holding on the offense. I've never actually seen holding on the defense. I wonder if that's even a penalty here in Madden. I've never seen it. So on a 3rd and goal, throw to the right side. It's caught but out of bounds by Keon Knight. And we do settle for the field goal. And now we do get the ball back with 2 minutes left here in this game. Our defense is playing really, really great in this one. Here's a throw to the sideline and a catch by Galladay. And that's a nice big gain for about 30 yards. And the Redskins call their first timeout. So now from the 19-yard line, this time Fields throws across the middle. It's a lob over the top of the linebacker and caught for the touchdown. It's Knight again. He is amazing. He's going to be fun to develop throughout this series. And we end up winning this game 22-10. Didn't put up big numbers throwing the ball, but 3 touchdowns for Fields. That's a pretty good game. Running the ball has been slower, and Kennedy Brooks not having himself, like I said, an amazing season. I'm thinking about putting Carey Reedy back in there. I guess we'll have to wait and see because we are winning games, so I don't want to change anything while we are winning. Knight goes over 100 yards, 131 yards on 7 receptions. Hockenson has 8 receptions of his own and a touchdown. And then on the defensive side of the ball, Trey Flowers, 3.5 sacks. He is always doing well for us. Remember the year when we were thinking about trading him or even letting him go in free agency? I am so glad we did not go down that route. So now we go up against an Eagles team who is 4-8, still led by 30-plus-year-old Carson Wentz. He is the number 21-ranked quarterback in the league. Man, I honestly wish Carson Wentz could just stay healthy in real life. I mean, man, it's kind of frustrating a little bit to see a guy with so much talent and he gets into the playoffs and then gets hurt. I mean, it is just frustrating. You hate to see it, really, unless you're a Giants fan or a Cowboys fan. But we end up winning that next game by 7 points over the Philadelphia Eagles. They do outshine us as far as yards go, but both quarterbacks throw two touchdowns and two interceptions, and Justin Fields gets sacked 5 times as Kennedy Brooks only runs for 50 yards, and that's the type of thing that I'm talking about. He just doesn't have those big games. But then Keon Knight, only one reception for 14 yards for him in that one, and it turns out that he has a ruptured disc. So he is going to be sidelined for the remainder of the season, it looks like, 8 weeks out. That's taking us all the way to the Super Bowl if we do make it back. So this is a big blow, because remember, we were also hoping that he would finish top five in touchdowns, catches, or yards, and it looks like that's now off the shelf. So he will not have an opportunity to upgrade that dev trait to the final one, which is Superstar X Factor. So we will have to rely on some backup receivers. Now, we did sign Henry Ruggs in the offseason, but now we will have to probably look at Marlon Yarbrough and Dustin Revolt. Now, remember Dustin Revolt? He was an undrafted free agent after season two, and he is developed pretty nicely, to be honest. He started as a 57 overall receiver. He's up to 74. I mean, that is a 17-point jump. I mean, that is the type of progression that I love this year in Madden, and it definitely makes it a lot of fun. So we are going up against Brent Thompson and the Carolina Panthers. Now, remember Brent Thompson in our Whitetail series? He was on that number one Ohio State team who we beat, who the Whitetails defeated in the conference championship for the first Big Ten title of the Whitetail series. And just looking at the Panthers, they still have Christian McCaffrey, who is still, after 7 seasons, under 30 years old. That just tells you how young this guy is and how bright of a future he has. I mean, he is really, really, really good. I mean, a lot of these teams that were saying before the draft, I remember before when he was getting drafted, they were saying that he would not last in the NFL, that he was just a third down back. I mean, that is just ridiculous now. As here's a throw across the middle, and Thompson almost turns it over to Jelani Tavai, and they do end up settling for the field goal. But now they take the 10-0 lead, and it looks like Carolina at home, looks like their crowd is behind them in this one. Here's a run out to the right side, and that's going to be Christian McCaffrey. He's already over 100 yards here in the first half, and it's not even to 5 minutes left here in the second quarter. Here's a screen pass out to the right side. It's going to be caught by DJ Moore and run in, and wow, Carolina's up 17-0. As here comes our offense back out onto the field, just trying to do something before halftime. Here's a catch across the middle, and that is a wide open Marlon Yarbrough, as he was alone on that one. He gets to about the 46. So he hurried up to the line this time, trying to throw the ball across the middle, and it's going to be a sack by Dana, and we do call a timeout. And now we get it to 1:04 left here in the first half. This time Fields throws left side. He's got a man open. It's going to be Galladay who goes up and gets it in traffic and holds on. And it is a first down, and Quincy Wilson is shaken up on that one. But that's a big gain by Galladay as we move it to about the 23-yard line. This time two backs in the backfield. Fields tries to step up and get rid of it, and he gets hit and fumbles it. And luckily Jack Spell is there to fall on it. And now that brings it to a 2nd and 19. Here is Fields from the shotgun, throws across the middle, and Galladay had a step, and he gets it. It's a first down, so we make up all that yardage. So 30 seconds left here in the first half. This time Fields throws across the middle. He's got Henry Ruggs, the speedy receiver out of Alabama, and he picks up about a gain of 6 yards. So 2nd and 4 this time from the shotgun. Fields tries to scramble up the middle. He tries to spin, and he does cough it up. And Carolina will fall on it. And take a look at this. It's going to be a foot race, and Marlon Yarbrough dives and misses. And that is going to be a scoop and score the other way. It's 24-0 here in the first half, and the Lions just never recover from this. We end up losing the game 38-6 as Carolina just absolutely puts the foot on the gas in this one. And honestly, losing Keon Knight definitely made an impact, had an impact on that game, as Christian McCaffrey ran for 217 yards in this one, 39 attempts. I mean, that's pretty much on par with what he would get in real life. But also, they had another carry, another running back who had 10 carries. I mean, that's 50 carries. I mean, that's just amazing. As now the Carolina Panthers give us our fourth loss, but we have clinched a playoff spot as our division is locked up. We are 10-4 ahead of the Bears with two games left. But now it's a race for that final first round bye in the NFC. So we will go up against the Rams next. And the Rams, remember, they are quarterbacked by Adrian Martinez. No more Jared Goff. He moved on to the Chargers. And here is the first play of the game. Here is Trey Flowers getting in, and he's well on his way to another double-digit sack season. That would be his fifth straight with us. As here's a throw across the middle on a 3rd-and-7, and that's going to be a tackle by Tracy Walker. And we are going to get them to settle for the field goal, and that makes it 3-0. So you can just see our offense is struggling to score when we get the ball. So here we are back on defense. This time, Adrian Martinez in the pocket, trying to scramble out. It makes Bryant Ryan miss, puts out a move, and gets to about the 6-yard line on that one. Tackled by Jelani Tavai, and it's a first down for the Rams. So now to start the second quarter, they have it inside the 5-yard line. Martinez, we're sending a blitz this time. He's going to throw to the end zone. It is caught by their tight end that time. I would say that's Tyler Higbee. I have no idea who that is, actually. And now he makes it 10-0. So here come the Lions back out onto the field. This time, 1st-and-10, throw across the middle. It's Galladay. He's got a lot of room, and I love Galladay. He's been healthy the last couple of seasons, and that's part of the reason why I've kept him around. He's been reliable as far as health. So 2nd-and-goal, quick throw right back to him. It's a touchdown, and we do cut this lead back down to just 3 points. And now it makes it interesting as we are trying to, like I said, clinch this first round bye. So 1st-and-10, here's a throw out to the right side on the next possession. Down 12-7, and that's caught on the sideline by Josh Oliver. So 45 seconds left here in the first half, but this time the Rams will get to us. It's a sack. And now that brings it to a 3rd-and-long with 40 seconds left. We do burn a timeout on that one. Fields moves out to the left side to give himself some time. He's going to throw on the run. He's got a man on the sideline. It is Galladay again who's going to have to step up in a big-time role with Keon Knight injured. So now we get it inside the 27-yard line. This time Fields, good blocking up front. He's going to take it himself down the right side, and he's going to kind of move out of bounds on this one and stop the clock. And now that brings it to within 15 seconds left, as here we are at the 15-yard line now with 7. After failing on a 1st down, 2nd-and-10, throw to the sideline. It's going to be caught in both feet down. It's a touchdown, Josh Oliver. And remember, he is the backup tight end. I love him as a backup. He's a big body guy. He can move, he can catch the ball, and he can block. And he does get us a score before halftime. And now we fast forward to the 4th quarter. Now down 15-14. You can just see our offense is just not the same without Keon Knight. He definitely made a huge impact, one that we did not see before. Throw to the end zone, and it's going to be intercepted by Johnson the third, and now the Rams take back over, but we do get possession back. Actually, we don't, and here come the Rams at about the 9-yard line on the other side of the field. Martinez, he's going to try to take it himself, and he does go down. That's Sean Chapman on the sack. And now that brings it to a 3rd-and-6. Now, Martinez has not been throwing the ball well, but he's been doing it with his legs. Throw to the end zone. And this time he does have Brandon Cooks in the back of the end zone. Man, that was a pinpoint throw over the top of the defense. And now it is 22-14. And wow, this first round bye might be slipping out of our hands. But here's a throw across the middle. That's actually tipped, and Hockenson comes back and gets it, as that is caught at about the 4-yard line. So 2 minutes left here in this game. Here is Fields this time, throwing across the middle. It's Galladay, he's got it. Another touchdown catch for him, and he does bring it to within 2 points. And we do have to go for the two-point conversion here, and we do not convert. So now we are down by 2 points, as now here comes Martinez back out onto the field. I said he likes to run the ball. Here he is scrambling to the right side, and he is going to pick up about a gain of 7 yards. And that brings it to a 2nd and 3 as we burn our first timeout. Throw to the right side. It's Cooper Kupp who gets it, and he cannot get upfield. And that brings it to a 3rd and 3. If he gets the first, it's a game over on this one. Running the ball up the middle, and it's going to be 1st down, 1st and 10. So the Rams upset us on the road as wow. Now we lose another game. This first round bye could be in jeopardy as now we have to win this last game. I mean, Galladay had 2 touchdowns. He did pretty well in this one. But you can just see the offense is compromised without that threat of Keon Knight of being able to do it all. I mean, that is just what it looks like right now. But luckily for us, the Giants have lost their last game and the Seahawks have lost the last 2. So we are still in the 2nd spot here in the NFC as the Buccaneers, remember, they are quarterbacked by D Bird, who we tried to trade for. They are in the 1st seed as they have home field advantage throughout. But now we go up against an 8-7 Bengals team who is now quarterbacked by Jameis Winston. Now, this is interesting. If it wasn't for Joe Burrow, I would say the Bengals probably might go after Jameis Winston, but I think it's a no doubt that they go after Joe Burrow in real life. But they also do have Jerry Jeudy, and you know, if Jameis Winston has receivers to throw to, he's just going to throw like 50 times a game and just throw it up. I mean, he literally had 30 touchdowns, 30 interceptions, the first quarterback to ever do that. And who ends their season on a pick six? I mean, that is just insane. But now here we go. A win here will secure that first round bye, and we will end up with the 2nd seed in the NFC, so we will need to be on our P's and Q's in this one. But look at the score. It's 16-2 as we move on to the 3rd quarter. Our offense is really, really lacking here without Keon Knight. Here's a throw to the right side as we try to make a little comeback as Fields has thrown 2 interceptions up to this point. So Fields throws across the middle at the 35-yard line. That's going to be caught by Marlon Yarbrough, who has been playing a bigger role with Knight out, and he gets a big 1st down. So now we're down by 2 scores to start the 4th quarter. This time Fields moves out to the right side, and he's got a lot of room, and he's going to go untouched. It's a touchdown, but we are now still down by 10 points. We have to kind of buckle down, and now we make it a 7-point game. I meant 8 points, not 10 points. And now it is 9-16 as here we are trying to make the comeback in this one. Throw across the middle. It's going to be Henry Ruggs. It's kind of confusing. He has Marvin Jones' old number, but he picks up the 1st down. So 1st and 20 this time. Fields, he has a lot of open room up the middle. And look at that. We may have missed Henry Ruggs for a touchdown because I did not see the safety not go with Henry Ruggs across the middle. But it ends up being a face mask anyway. We get a big gain, and we move it to about the 4-yard line. So no harm, no foul on that one. Fields throws across the middle. It's caught by Dustin Revolt, who we just got done talking about in the beginning of this episode. And there he gets in for his 1st touchdown. And now we tied this game up, and maybe the comeback is real. Fields now 16-16, throw across the middle, and that's Ruggs for a 1st down, and he gets it to about the 50-yard line. Is now there's under 2 minutes left here as we bring it to a 3rd and 11 at the 49. Fields, this is a big play on this one, changing the play at the line. He's going to throw across the middle. He's got Josh Oliver, and it is caught. And there we go. We are set up inside field goal range, so we are just going to knee the ball, and Cincinnati does call timeouts, and here we are lined up for the game-winning field goal, and it is just a chip shot, and we will hit that, and there we go. We have locked up that 1st round bye, but man, it has come at an expense. Keon Knight is out for the playoffs, and this is going to be tough because you can see how much our offense is struggling now without Knight. Yarbrough does go over 100 yards in this one. We definitely needed it, but I think we're going to have to use Henry Ruggs and his speed to our advantage somehow, some way. Marlon Yarbrough is actually fast as well. He's got 93 speed, and our defense is going to need to play really, really, really well, as Jameis Winston did throw for 248 yards, a touchdown, and an interception. And we do lock up that number 2 seed as Jameis Winston's former team gets the number one seed as we do go 11-5. Remember, even last year, we went 10-6. So we actually had a better season during the regular season this year than last. So here are the playoff matchups in the wild card round. The Ravens, Browns, Bears, Giants, Texans, Jaguars, and Falcons, Seahawks. So we will maybe even end up playing the Chicago Bears again. Man, that would suck because that would be the third straight year we would end up playing the Bears. The fourth straight year, actually, that we'd end up playing the Bears in the playoffs. So that is going to do it for season 7. So let's just recap this season and just look at the player stat-wise and just see, you know, who had a great season. Now, Justin Fields had the same year that he's been having, to be honest. He did surpass 4,000 yards, but at the running back position, Kennedy Brooks, he hasn't really impressed. He ran for 728 yards. We have not had an 1,000-yard rusher at all in this series. And you can just see the other running backs. Eckler was pretty good. Reedy was all right. I mean, I think we just need a change at running back, and I think that's what we're going to address going into the offseason. We did lock up Brooks, so he does, you know, he gets paid a little bit of money, but it's not like top dollar for a running back. So receiving-wise, Knight does end up about 150 yards short of a 1,000-yard season, but that's because of his injury. Galladay ends up 50 yards short as well, but you know what? I'm pretty proud of this team. I think this team is really, really good, and we have a lot of good pieces in place, at least to contend in the future and keep contending, and I really like that. You know, the way we built this team, I think we built it from the ground up, just going from the draft, not really signing older free agents and kind of trading for guys. We pretty much just relied on the draft here. As you can just see the defense. I mean, looking at Rich Patton, for the first time, he did not have any interceptions in the regular season. He had 4 sacks, and he actually did lead our team in tackles, which is different. I mean, usually we have, you know, a guy like Jelani Tavai leading us, but you know what? Rich Patton did his thing, and I gotta say, man, this team is just loaded, and every position. I mean, Tracy Walker, Trey Flowers, James Anderson. I mean, there's so much depth on this team that, I mean, we're just set up to win. I mean, we're just set up to win every single year, and I'm excited to see what this team can really, really do. We have 2 Super Bowls in 6 seasons, trying to make it 3 in 7 seasons. But I do want to talk about some veterans here, like Trey Flowers, and this guy is just amazing. I'm so glad we did not get rid of him. And just looking at his stats, I mean, he's been beasting for us. 5 straight seasons with double-digit sacks. This one, he has 12. Last year was his career high, 15.5. But, I mean, just right on par with what he's doing. I mean, it even looks like he's getting better with age because he had 11 sack season, 10.5 sack season. Then he follows that up with 15.5 and 12. So, I mean, look at the solo tackles as well. Those have went up. So when he's given more responsibility, it seems like he's just living up to the bill. So around the league, and this is a surprise, Marcus Mariota is going to win the NFL MVP. I mean, that would probably never happen, especially since he's not even the starter anymore. And I'm excited to see, where will Mariota go in real life? I mean, I doubt he's going to stay with the Titans. I'm pretty sure he's going to go for a starting job. Maybe even Tampa Bay to replace Jameis Winston. That would be pretty funny to see the number 2 pick in that draft replace the number 1 pick. So we did not really have any impact rookies. Like I said, this is probably one of our weaker draft classes that we've had, and really no rookie has made an impact this year. But I have, you know, I'm optimistic about just the youth of this team. Like I said before, D'Angelo Boone actually finished 2nd in best offensive lineman, and then Trey Flowers finished 3rd in best defensive end. But we pretty much had no award winners except our kicker, Joe Gammon. He was hitting monster field goals all throughout the year, but I don't know how the game even calculates that. I mean, he didn't miss a field goal, really. I mean, he maybe missed like a couple, but I guess he just wins the award over everybody else. So we are going into the playoffs, and we will see who we will play next episode. We do get that first round bye, so that will be nice to give our guys some rest. So that's going to do it here in the regular season in season 7 as we head into the playoffs full steam. Hit subscribe. Hit that like button. Stay tuned. Let's get it. Let's go.
Yeah, hey, filling out these job applications. Life got hard after high school graduation. I went to college and your boy got financial aid. They gave me money, then I went and bought a pair of J's. And I bought a pair of shades. And I bought a new computer. Half $400 left, spent the rest on...